We all have hopes and dreams for our retirement. The income that replaces your wages will prove to be the key to attaining the quality of life in retirement that you envision. Social Security income is a starting point, although some people fear that this reserve will be depleted before they retire. Income from a pension plan or other retirement plan may augment Social Security income. Regardless of these sources, managing the income from your investments will require a more active role. During retirement, many people want to increase their share of income-producing investments or seek more security and less risk. It is impossible to predict the best time to move from one particular investment class into another, from stocks into bonds, for example. One recommended strategy is to shift investments gradually, perhaps over 2 or 3 years. This kind of transitioning reduces the impact of the market environment at any one point in time. Taxes and transaction costs of transitioning these investments will need to be factored into the equation. Some of your retirement income will be paid regularly and automatically, for instance, Social Security benefits or required minimum distributions. So if you need additional income to meet expenses, which investments should you use? From a tax perspective, withdrawing money from an IRA doesn't make sense if it isn't necessary because these investments are earning tax-deferred income. Once you reach age 70 and a half, you will, by law, have to begin regularly scheduled withdrawals, referenced earlier, as required minimum distributions. Many professionals suggest setting up a spending account that can provide a source of additional income to meet your regular expenses when other sources are insufficient. A spending account should be made up of liquid assets, such as a money market fund. The ideal rule of thumb is to keep enough in the account to meet 1 year's expenses. Of course, the amount in the fund will fluctuate as you make withdrawals and additions to the account. One of your main goals is to ensure that enough remains in your investment portfolio to last for the rest of your life. There is certainly no shortage of opinions and studies on the subject of retirement savings. During the bull market years of the 1990s, some retirement planners suggested that you could withdraw 5 to 6% a year without eating into your principal, but others have put the rate in a more conservative 3 to 4% range. In today's financial climate, you may want to be even more conservative if you can afford to do so. Obviously, more than numbers will enter into your decision, such as how comfortable you are about having enough money to last through retirement, even when you have run the calculation. Also, how will your expenses change with your retirement activities? And what are your feelings about how much you want to leave to your heirs?